what day is it? What day is it? Is it a Friday? Can we carry the Friday vibe? Because damn, the Monday vibe has jumped. Anyway, welcome back from your weekend. My weekend, if asked, same old, but hey. It's Covered Scoop. My name is Tina VS1, and today's mood is just blah. Welcome. Yeah. Yo, did you guys see that Don Zella thingy? The Don Zella live thing. You dancing it? Where she was on Facebook Live in her underwear? I'm still trying to make believe that to be honest, I honestly believe that thing was just, it could be, do you think Charlie Chikade? Nga, someone just brought it back. Nobody was the night. What, depends on what color of underwear are you talking about. I saw the one where she was wearing red underwear, then the one where she was wearing pink underwear, and the one where she was wearing a white bra. They're pink in Kade. Okay, I'm sorry, but for me, that if it's an old thingy doing its rounds, oh wow, wow. Now I know why I can't be in a twisted part of the world like that. Like, at times I notice that if I associate or if I try to get stories on particular type of people, I might end up being like them. Because, I mean, like, for real? Like, it just flabbergasted me. Like, chick is on Facebook in her underwear, showing us her titties and her somewhat covered cookie. No, sorry, let me take that back. Don Zella's is not a cookie. What name can we give it? Sourdough? Could be sourdough. I'm just saying. Hey, I watched the thing in disbelief. I'm like, you have got to be emotionally deprived, or the high grade you're smoking has got to be a particular strand, or the cocaine is finally hitting you in ways that can't give you shakes anymore, that you look normal. Like, you have got to be up on some bullshit to actually do that. Whenever na Uganda, why do you guys want validation so much? I mean, I know it could be an old thing doing rounds, but and Jebus, yeah, but what at the time she was doing it, what was it going to achieve? Because we have to start somewhere and have market. I want to get Don Zella. You know what? In the long run, I'm going to make a comparison that's going to make people get pissed off. But if you ask me, who do I need in society and less of in society? In society, I would rather deal with bad black any day than deal with Don Zella, Akina Who, Akina Slay Cows and Slay Cartoons. Because with bad black, I'm sure she's going to stand up in the morning and tell me I'm a hoe. And I'm sure she's going to tell me I got money, cause I'm a hoe. And I have babies, cause I'm a hoe. So at each point, she's a hoe. You know what's paying her bills. I would deal with someone that honest. She is honest to self. To self. I saw her stomach. I'm like, even I didn't have my stomach issues, but I'm not yet that bulge. I will keep saying the words. With great power comes great responsibility. Decide who you give the power, because you have to face the consequences of responsibility, people. These women are out here on Facebook. They don't want to watch it yet. They don't want to watch it yet. They don't have sex on Facebook. Grown as fuck women! Grown as fuck! They're out here still looking for a like or two. Trick! You shouldn't stay on speak road. pawing on Facebook. Obuduka abo mwetu bukoye mu busengulo bambufula bu supermarket nga abalala. We can't be doing this on Facebook. We can't. And you know what's annoying? The people who actually make these women keep coming back are the bloggers. Someone's going to say, Tina, aren't you a blogger? No, I'm not a blogger, boo boo. I am a TV host. Thank you. Two different things. Two different things. I have a profession. Never get into that call. But blogger, man, we baba take ayo. Nagamba. Oli trending akurita kagwa. They're like, okay, let's do more of this shit. Bossa. Who is the bossa here? I know. I mean, me, I'm no blogger. Thank you for putting up scoop on scoop, but we're good in either light. In any way. On our Facebook, we're good on our Book a day na show, Bajita and one of those. You people. I don't know what's wrong with my president. Yes, I'm saying it. I don't know what's wrong with my president. But I think it's the people around him who are just giving him the wrong advice. So over the weekend, we got up to official news that Butcherman and Catherine Kusasira are officially, what are they? President. Hi, Jesus. My weak heart. My weak heart cannot take this nyokari. Mr. President. Now, this one I'm asking as a concerned citizen. Please, dear at Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, I, a humble muzukuru / immunized muzukuru, would like to understand of what importance Butcherman is going to be to a ghetto youth. I would like to know of what importance Catherine Kusasira is going to be to the youth. And then I would most especially love to know how those sit-down sessions between you and them will go. So what? Butcherman is going to go to the ghetto, rally up the troops that are not with the other party, and come back for a review. And it's like, yes, Mr. President, kati watu wade tuwa gede na kati mugeto. Yeah. Watu alia vana bikumi bisatu, teba ina mirimo, teba asoma kubibu anjai. Uwetuli is like, okay, my son, thank you for representing. How do you advise? Zembate ngamba baba ongele njali. I cannot! For the love of me! I know it's 2020 and the crazies are coming out, but dear Mr. President, you cannot embarrass yourself like this. I don't know what abantu abakuliriranye tebakwagaliza, but this is embarrassing. What is Butcherman going to do? Butcherman was in, he was in the ghetto. Even before Bobby White left the ghetto. And still, he's in the ghetto. He's going to be advising you from the ghetto. People, keyword, ghetto. Now let me tell you another smart thing. Abana manja abakuli demu ghetto, banji nyo, banji nyo. No, the president you wamu, bamu itani ulimulele. Bobby White, na ya gamba ya kuli demu ghetto, but I explained that to you. It's different when you own the land in that ghetto. That doesn't make... Is you... Yeah, is you a ghetto president? Haka, muli mwesa lako wanonga mwaba si baba ugona people power. Hold it. Like, I need people to understand that tewali agenda kujamu ghetto. Tewali agenda kugenda advising a president aja kujemu ghetto. I don't know why you don't know that or see that. Getting out of the ghetto, it's all up in here. It's you. You. You wake up one day and you're like, F it, I'm done, let me go. Even those people who are coming from the ghetto, who you're seeing, oh, one is now running for presidential something and then Butcherman is with another president. Nabo benini. It was entirely up to them. Now, of course, someone is going to be like, this is a conspiracy theory, because, I mean, Butcherman was Bobby Wine's right-hand man for time immemorial, so if there's anyone who knows where the bodies are buried, It's gonna be butcher man posing up as moving. It's a metaphor. Don't get confused. Banganamoa V8 Ajivuki Sage. Have they given him a prosthetic leg yet? Is it, what is it called? Prosthetic? I don't really care. I'm tired of Museveni just embarrassing my mind thought, like my train of thought like that. Like, here I am going like, yeah, finally we're getting political maturity. My president is mature. The guys is going to stand up against the also and somewhat mature. Did I just do scoop on the president of this here nation? Yep. Like I said, we have friends and family package one. Monday. My Monday is actually getting off to a good start after all. A certain thief apparently wants to sue me. You know what? Let me even go for me. Maybe we are Gwanga. The whole Makere situation with the strikes going on and all of that. So much has been said, so much has been talked about. We're trying to come to a conclusion, but here's what I'm going to say. This is how I want to look at it. If it's possible for the Makere students, Mutuyam, because talking to the kids who are there, they'll tell you, Fetuavi Sanga, Tujabide Kao, it is mandatory, we strike. Some of the people actually striking don't even know why they are striking, and some of it has even turned into politics. But still, that I do not condone what happened. I don't know which I don't know if it was the police or the military or whatever for breaking into people's rooms and beating them at night. That is so cowardly in so many ways. But here's my perspective. I'm saying, why is it our kids are the ones being beaten up with tear gas canisters and all of these things? Yet, if we're being candid about it, it's us, the parents, abayinokuba up in arms whenever there's an increment on that tuition, because let's not forget it, faba sasula tuition. So I would say, here's a simple solution. Let the kids put down their armor, let them sit, go back to their lecture rooms, and let it be us, the parents, abakutukanezo sento kuziba sasulida abafune an education, take up the walk, not our kids. Because first of all, mucha alibatonyo. They are throwing you in all these detention centers because, for what? Sante simu hava zitola. Mugende mkolevi hava tuwala yokusoma. Nafe tukolevi bituino kola. Sasula tuition. But ulilanga tunyigiri ziduanga hava zadi. Let us get up and stop the conversation. Not you. And that's how I'm seeing it for me. But it's sad what's going on. It's really sad. And as of today, we're just hoping they do come to an understanding. I'll delve into that another time. Anywho, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Not forgetting, on Instagram we are at TinaFierce1 with an 8, and on Snapchat. Yeah, Randell, shut up. I've still failed to use her. I still don't know how to use Snapchat, but I'm learning it. Yes, on Snapchat it's at TinaFierce1. For now though, I'm out. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. Peace.